damn it, that intro keeps zoning us.
Oh my gosh, that's twice today. All right, here we go. We have the Terran now. We have MVP on the bottom left, as we have our Zerg, Fire Fist, on the top right of Chukwungnyeong, our second game and second map.
Well, as we said before, our Terran player was not playing well. There's a shot of him now. You can see, yeah, he's just trying to take a deep breath.
He's not even looking at the screen. What's he doing?
Well, probably trying to collect his thoughts. I mean, it's, you know, only the first minute that we're in right now.
Yeah.
And, you know, with that being said, there's actually not a whole lot going on. You know, I once saw somebody say, when I was at a tournament, he says, you know, I once saw this Korean pro gamer, and he had 400 actions in the first minute of the game. And I was like, yeah, but he's just spamming, man, because there's really only about 4 or 5 actions you need to perform in the first minute of the game. But a lot of these players do start spamming early, because if the game picks up, you really do need to get that APM going.
Yeah, it's just warming up for their hands. They just kind of need to get used to getting faster and faster during the game.
All right, well, Terran sneaking out here. You know, we saw a strategy earlier where we saw one supply depot, and actually, you know what, that might have been another game I cast, but I've seen strategies where players will make one barracks in the main and then make another barracks outside, the second one outside the Zerg's expansion, and then do a rush from there. So Zerg, I think what Terran's actually going to do is do a bunker rush, but a harder bunker rush than what it looks like. Some Terran players will do kind of a fake bunker rush with one off one barracks, and meanwhile they're actually just expanding. But this is actually going to be a pretty serious aggressive strategy here from our Terran player. And it's certainly one he's practiced before. I mean, you know, if you've never played this map in a serious match before, you can't just sit down and, you know, be like, oh, well, let's try this.
Yeah.
So Zerg's going to scout this and see one barracks. Probably assume that the Terran's going to be making a command center too. It looks like Zerg's going to send his drone back right away anyways. What I'm worried about, though, is that the distances here are really far apart. You know, it's not like a Marine can get there quickly. Is he actually going to expand? Maybe he's trying to make it look like he's going to expand. I'd be shocked, actually, if he made a command center right away. I seriously think this is a big mind game that the Terran player is trying to set up by putting the SCV out there. Because I don't know why else he would hide a barracks. And I've been wrong before. You know, out of all the matchups that I'm the weakest at casting, I think TBZ is the one I have. I'm a Protoss player. My brother was a Zerg player. We were both competitive gamers. But yeah, I mean, you know, sometimes in a matchup like this, I could be wrong. Okay, but it does look like it's going to be a bunker rush. And it's going to be a real bunker rush. And Zerg's, Zerg's going to be shocked when he sees, oh, SCV, stopping the drone. Zerg's going to be in shock right now when he sees this many Marines. I mean, it's going to be twice as many Marines as he would have expected. Now, however, if Zerg holds this off, Terran is in trouble. All right, a few more links come out here. Here come the SCVs. Oh, Zerg leads do get in there and take out the Marines, and this strategy is not going to work.
Oh, no.
Terran should have done a better job blocking with the SCVs and also using his Marines well. Now Terran has pulled off all these extra SCVs for nothing. Zerg's going to go ahead and get the extractor out now. Oh man, this could be bad. Well, the Zerg's going to get a second sunken colony. We may see the Zerg respond by getting a few more speedlings, but Terran, of course, wants to expand, so we'll see Terran probably get a command center here when he feels comfortable, unless he gets his gas before the command center, in which case he's going to play very low econ style.
So comparing this guy's style to Toss Girl, can you tell me what he's doing better? Or not.
The thing is, Terran really messed up that rush. I mean, he's really hurt from that rush.
Well, minus that rush, I guess. I guess it just seemed more apparent to me when Toss Girl was getting owned and...
Yeah, I know what you mean. Well, I think with our Zerg, first of all, the Zerg seems to be playing a little bit better, to be honest.
Right.
But also, a Toss Girl's build didn't seem to be quite as calculated. Does that make sense?
Yes, it does.
I mean, at least this build seems to be very well orchestrated. But I don't know, Toss Girl, the thing that we really saw her fall apart on was the mid-game. I mean, that was really the point where it was like, oh, okay, she's not quite up to par right now.
Mm-hmm.
Where here we're seeing our Terran player fall apart more in the early game. We haven't really gotten the opportunity to see this guy play mid-game because he lost so quickly in the last one. And, you know, that's something that happens, you know. I mean, Aydra, for instance, is a player. And you'll have a lot of people, even Koreans or non-Koreans say this. You know, Aydra is a player who does so well mid-game to late-game, but early-game is his weakness. And this might be the same thing for this Terran player. Layer's done. I think we're going to see Lurkers, judging from the Hydralisk den. Zerg's probably going to try to do a Lurkerling break at the front, and I think that's really, really smart. In fact, I'm almost positive that the Terran is not going to be able to stop a Lurkerling break. You know, I was honestly expecting Mutalisks. I'm just so used to seeing Mutalisks in this matchup.
Oh, but yeah.
I think this is actually pretty smart because Terran doesn't have a back expansion. This expansion is pretty vulnerable. Terran already lost a bunch of Marines. His Econ is down because he was forced to take off so many SCVs to try to make that rush work, and it didn't work. That now the front is going to be pretty vulnerable. Terran may try to skip the bunker to get a better economy. You know, he doesn't want to waste 100 minerals on that. He wants to, you know, spend that kind of money on another barracks. And you can see Zerg's not interested at all in letting Terran get that far out. He's going to take out this SCV, no problem. And we're going to see a lot of Lurkers up here in a little bit. And Terran is also going to, you know, going to be in a bad situation a little bit here, too. He's going to have two scanners out here. The Hydralisk Den is in the location that Terran is not likely to scan. Terran might be expecting two hatch all in Mutalisks right now. Zerg's going to go ahead and expand here. Excuse me, Zerg's going to go ahead and attack the expansion here. Tasteless versus logical sentences here. So you see, the thing is, actually, you know, he's probably going to use those two scans to scan the main and the expansion. Now, it would have been smarter for the Zerg to morph the Lurkers near the Hydralisk Den, or the Terran's unlikely to expand. Once again, Zerg goes in there and snipes. Those units now going in here, going to attack the Fireback. Great micro there by the Terran. All right, here we go. Now this is the moment of truth. And you can see Terran probably spotted the Lurker eggs when he scanned the expansion. Now he's going to try to rush out here and contain these Lurkers. And surprisingly enough, the Zerg is not going to move forward. Man, Terran is playing like crap right now. I don't know why he's letting this happen. Oh, no! Two medics gone. That's not good. Terran scans the Queen's Nest. Zergling Lurker is going to be the name of the game right now. See, this is the thing that Terran's doing wrong, is you can't contain someone on this map. And he's trying to contain him like the Zerg's going to go right through the middle. Instead, Zerg goes ahead and expands to the top left. And I think we may see Zerg try to break this. He's going to send one Zergling out here. He wants to figure out exactly where this army is located. All right, the Hive's on the way. We're going to see fast defilers. Again, the Terran, his tech is going to be behind. He doesn't even have a starport up yet. He might have one after this factory finishes. And it just did. All right. Spire is coming up here pretty soon. Surprisingly, the Zerg is not going to play as aggressively as we thought. I think what the Zerg player is thinking is that, look, he feels like he's already stronger than the player. He thinks he's already scared the crap out of him in that last game. Instead, he's just going to go ahead and, you know, play a little bit more passively. He might attack here in a second, but that's probably why he didn't attack earlier. Terran's going to be in for a bit of a surprise here. We could see, no, he scans, he spots it. Thank God Terran didn't walk into that. You know, after Brood War came out, you know, it was just originally StarCraft, but after Brood War came out, Blizzard put so many more really interesting units into the game. I mean, like Lurkers, I mean, you can wipe out a whole group of Marines, you know, in two hits.
Yeah.
And, you know, you get the Medic, you know, Terran can have Stim, you know, so many times more. All right, Terran's now going to try to go around the Zerg. a little bit of a role reversal here. All right, Terran's going to move around now. Now, I don't know if Zerg's aware of this or not, but Zerg's about to see it. Terran should stim. No! That lurker moves out of the way. Now, this means I think Zerg's going to attack the front. A lot of bunkers here, though. But he's going in for the kill right now. These lurkers are going to wipe out these bunkers, no problem. Those fire bats did do a lot of damage there. Oh my gosh. An unexpected amount of damage was dealt there to that Zerg lurker group. I think he should have target fired the bunker that had the fire bats in it, because the bunkers in the... I don't know. I just thought that was going to do more damage. So that was a blunder by the Zerg. That's going to give the Terran a little bit more ground here.
Oh, where's his medics?
There they are.
Oh, okay.
This is like... freshman homecoming or whatever, you know, and all the girls are in one place and all the guys are in another place. And I think, I don't know. Terran's going to need to start attacking either this top left expansion or this kind of middle north expansion. You know, the thing is that neither of these expansions are very accessible for the Terran, and I think that was smart for the Zerg to expand in that top left area next. Dropships is going to be the next answer for Terran. He's going to split this up and try to attack multiple locations at once. I question how effective this will be with the Nidus Canal up. All right. As you can see, Zerg has a very healthy tech here. He's already regenerated that entire army. Whoa! A lot of fire bats here, yet surprisingly, he didn't drop right in the mineral patches. You know, he's got to get out of there. That's what I was about to say. And goodbye. This is just not going well for Terran.
Zerg is doing whatever he wants, and he's succeeding.
That's exactly what's happening. It's just like, you know, Zerg just kind of tossed away a lot of units, and it still, was not very effective, for the Terran. Obviously, it was not effective for the Zerg, but you know what I'm saying. All right, well, now Zerg's going to really move down here. Zerg has plus one armor, Terran has plus one attack. And see, with Dark Swarm up, I just don't know if Terran's going to have, enough irradiates. I mean, Terran's going to get that vessel out so late because he did the two barracks build.
This guy needs to live up to his name. MVP, come on.
All right, a lot of Zerglian Lurker going to move out here now. Now, I think he's probably going to go right for the main. I don't think he needs to engage that army. All he has to do is get Lurkers with Dark Swarm at that command center, and that's it. Because once you get the Lurkers under there, there's very little that the opponent can do. Those Marines did a lot of kills. Got a lot more kills than I expected. But here's the dreaded moment of truth. And if you scorch spot, yes, they have. Bam! Goodbye. Now I think he's going to move up to the main with those lurkers, and if he can burn them right in front of the barracks, and yes, he will, it's over. That is it. He's done. Terran's going to try to do some all-in attack that won't work anyways, because Zerg's going to have Dark Swarm. There's a Dark Swarm now. Bam! Oh, and Plague to add insult to injury. Terran is just getting manhandled this game. Well, if he wants to cancel the hatchery, he can, but it really does not matter. Wow, Plague tanks just disappearing. Terran probably going to take a moment to breathe, let this whole loss sink in. There it is. Good game. GG. GG MVP.
I know.
Damn. I guess that stands for most vulnerable player. Firefist just dominated.
That was a quick 2-0. Yeah.
Yeah, that was our shortest series we've casted, actually. That was shorter than the Toss Girl series.
I know. Oh, wow. You're right.
MVP is just digesting that loss. And you can see disappointment. I mean, that is not a happy face.
Firefist, he had control both games. He knew exactly what he was doing. He played it like he was just like hanging out with his friends on Battle.net or something, and MVP couldn't follow.
Yeah, MVP just was not able to. Well, first of all, I think that rush was not well practiced.
No.
I mean, granted, I said he practiced it. I don't think it was practiced enough because the timing of it was just off. I mean, he even stopped the Zerg for a second from getting the Sunken Colony up, and it still didn't work. How does that happen? I mean, I don't know.
He
should have just sent more SCVs. You know what I mean? The locations are so far apart, I don't even know if that strategy's good.
Yeah.
It takes forever to get your Marines from there to there. He should have just made the proxy barracks, like proxy double barracks, like outside of the Zerg's main or something.
I don't know. I mean, yeah, in the beginning it looked like he had something systematical, like worked out, like he knew it was going to do.
And then
he just kind of fell apart, and Firefist definitely took advantage of that.
Yeah.
He just bulldozed over that one.
Yeah, so. No kidding. Good word choice. He just got bulldozed. Well, we're going to be taking a break here in a little bit.
Yeah.
Maybe in a minute or two.
And then our last matchup, Boxer.
Excellent.
And Bi Hero. Another Terran versus Zerg. I'm excited.
I'm pumped.
After Thursday's amazing performances, who knows what Boxer's got in store for us this time around.
Yeah, no kidding. Now, Hero is a little bit more of an accomplished player. When you compare them
more so than Baxter.
Yeah.